So he's been vetted, and he's really great. So you're in this hotel room, and you're meeting with him. And at the start of the meeting, he says, listen, before we meet, I want to tell you, I've given you everything. I've told you everything that's been true. You saved American lives. Now you're going to do something for me. You're going to go out and you're going to get me a prostitute right now, or I'm never cooperating with you again. So I want to see a show of hands. How many people would get him a prostitute? Some. Not many. The answer is sure. I mean, you know, he's a scumbag, of course, but your job is to deal with scumbags, and you would be expected to go out and get him a prostitute. What if he asks for a child prostitute? Absolutely not. Under any circumstances. But that's not the CIA talking, that's John Kiriani talking. Because there's no rule. Your job as a CIA case officer is to break the laws of the country that you're serving in. That's your job. Your job is to commit espionage, which in most countries is a death penalty crime. Your job is to convince people to commit treason for you because they like you so much, or they like the money that you're giving them so much. So, because it's the nature of your job to break the law, there are no rules that are written for you to carry out that job. Now, the problem there is that most CIA case officers would procure the child prostitute. And even if they felt funny about it, they would be told by headquarters, you have a job to do. This is a bona fide source here. Go do your job. That's the problem, or the nature of the problem, of ethics and intelligence operations. There are no ethics and intelligence operations. I've come to the conclusion, after all these years, that there probably doesn't need to be a CIA. I think that David Patrick Moynihan was right in 1976 when he said that the CIA should be broken up. John Kennedy was right in 1963 when he said the CIA should be broken up.